Greetings, everyone, and welcome back once more to Dark Souls 3. So, after the usual fashion, I've done some revisiting previous areas in between the last recording session and this one. Additionally, on a tip from several people in the comments and on Twitter, I came back here to check on Giant Bro after having visited all three white birch trees. I must say, I'm rather saddened by what I've found. For no apparent reason, he appears to be dead. And there's an item on the ground, which a number of people have told me I would very much appreciate. And I think I have a fairly good idea of what this item is going to be. Yeah, it is exactly as I thought. Ring associated with Hawkeye Goff, one of the four knights of Gwyn, the First Lord. In his later years, the giant Goff was blinded, but this did not prevent him from striking down a calamitous dragon with his great bow. Really, they couldn't think of anything else to write in the description of this ring? Well, I mean, at least they're staying true to the story of the previous game, I guess. Yeah, so that's that. Rip, Giant Bro. And another thing, I have not actually acquired Goff's greatbow yet, but that's pretty much it. That's almost exactly the bow that Goff used. But this guy does not appear to drop a soul. Or I would have thought I'd received it by now. So I have no idea whether or not you can actually get Goff's greatbow in this game. I also noticed I somehow managed to miss this. Which, of course, is just a worthless soul. I don't know why I even bothered. But, I'm not going to warp back to Firelink Shrine just yet, because as it turns out, on my way here, I discovered something else that apparently I missed. I decided on a whim to check out Irina's cell on my way up to the tower, and apparently Egon is in here dead, once again, for absolutely no obvious reason at all. So I'm guessing, yes, of course, Morn's Great Hammer and the Moaning Shield. Moaning Shield? My god, this has a high strength requirement. A deformed great shield given to Egon of Kareem upon being conferred knighthood. The giant woman's face that protects Egon is that of his sister, some years his senior. In its skill, offer a gentle prayer to the shield, causing the woman's face to give out a low moan and attract enemies. Oh my god. I've got to give this a try. Actually, gotta see what the face is. That's his sister? Was she a Roman empress or something? Okay, well, what about that skill? Oh, right, and I guess I need to regenerate some FP first. Yeah, so I realized that Patches sells parrying daggers. I didn't notice that when I first searched through his inventory. And upon closer examination, it turns out the parrying daggers weigh considerably less than the Painting Guardian sword or the regular dagger, and they seem to have an increased parry frame window while having apparently almost exactly or exactly the same parry timing as the Painting Guardian sword. So these just made more sense in every conceivable way than what I was using before, and I've gone ahead and upgraded them with both Blessed and Simple infusions. And if I can find enough slabs, I'm going to max them out, I think. All right, let's see. I don't know if this is actually working correctly. Oh my god, well, I was thinking I might try and use Morn's Great Hammer, but 30 faith? And it's a pure physical weapon. You don't even get any elemental damage out of it. Why? Great Hammer bestowed upon Kareem Knights who demonstrate outstanding strength and unwavering faith. They must have been in a real rush to revise this text before the game went gold, is the only thing I can think. And even after. Decorated by a warding charm of Kareem Temple and imbued with the twisted rage of Apostle Morn. Stick weapon into the earth and emit a powerful shockwave. Also similar to Perseverance, temporarily boosts poise and reduces damage received. Wow. Well, okay. Oh, yeah, and the other thing. I decided, since it turns out I can use the sniper crossbow if I put on both dexterity rings, I decided I'd keep this around for sniping and just use the arbalest for its higher damage in normal situations. Since I'm going to be sniping from safe positions anyway, I presume that I'll have time to swap in those two rings in any situation when I might feel compelled to use the sniper crossbow. So yeah, gonna go for that too. And now we are done here, so we can head back to Firelink Shrine. However, I have also received another tip via YouTube comments and Twitter, indicating to me that Grey Rat is indeed probably dead at this point, and that I should go back and check freaking Irithyll again to claim his remains. Saddens me that I let poor Grey Rat down, but what can you do? It is a first playthrough after all, and I know people were yelling at me. I seem to have also apparently let Sigurd down as well, as a result of having not thought to go back and examine the well that I thought was suspicious when I first went by it during my foray into the cathedral, but apparently at that point I was already too late because I had saved the cathedral for last and not cleared it immediately. Oh well. Maybe on New Game Plus. Oh, attack behind them. Didn't realize that. Boy, well, this weapon sure trivializes these encounters now, doesn't it? Yeah, and there's I'm sorry, Grey Rat. Umbral Ash of Grey Rat of the Undead Settlement. With this, the Shrine Handmaid will prepare new items. Grey Rat was a thief who fancied himself a martyr for the poor, which is what drove him to climb the wall. Well, sorry, Grey Rat. I did my best. And, yeah. Apparently, I was supposed to meet Sigurd here. Damn it all. Oh well, I guess, let's go back and hand in Grey Rat's remains. hopefully this will allow me to start buying crossbow ammunition again, because, yeah,
oh,
not having a source of crossbow ammo kind of sucks.
Gracious, and awfully warm at that, almost as if it had lived mere moments ago. Oh, forgive an old woman's idle prey. I'm sure an ashen one such as thee would never indulge such base contrivances.
Oh, I guess that's supposed to be, if you go out of your way to kill somebody who is still alive and then hand her their ashes. She's like, oh, I would never imply that you murdered somebody for this. Oh. So we get a divine blessing and a hidden blessing. And oh, okay. So I guess this is stuff that holy cow, you can buy the Scholar's Candlestick and the Lothric Knight Sword and the Lothric Knight Greatsword. Wow. And the Lothric Knight Spear. Okay, so, and the crossbow. I guess, this is the result of him looting Lothric Castle. Because, yeah, you can get the Lothric Knight Shield and the Great Shield. And I presume probably their armor as well. Elite Knight stuff, the Faram stuff, Lautrec stuff, Egon's. Yeah, and all of the armor that Grey Rat sold is available here as well. Yeah, the Black Hand hat, the Black Hand armor. Oh, thank God, and ammunition. And wow! Okay, now I know where to get all of that stuff. I see. Dark arrows, moonlight arrows, great arrows. And lightning bolts. It's a shame that the elemental bolts from Dark Souls 2 didn't come back. Those were kind of a cool idea. Well, time to stock up on heavy bolts. And how about that? I had just enough souls.
Ashen one. Ashen one.
Well, it's a damn shame about Grey Rat. But what can you do? All right, so I think all I have left is to go deal with Prince Lothric. And yeah, I think it's from here, I believe there's an elevator that goes directly up there. The only thing is, there were something like 5 shortcut elevators in this zone, so I'm gonna have my work cut out for me figuring out which one is the one that goes up to the boss room entrance. I hope I can remember. It was either that one in there, or I think it might have been this one. Was it this one? I don't remember. Actually, oh, it looks like you can, stand on the roof of this, because it's flat. It's kind of cool. Oh, but I can't, you know, I don't think I've looked in the elevator shaft of this yet, either. Nope. Well, I don't think this is the correct elevator. I do not think this is the right one. I believe that... You know what? I know which elevator it was. It was the one in there. At least I think it was. Because I'm pretty sure that... Yeah, because that's that long bridge with all those Lothric knights with the blue surcoats. And I think the elevator in there is supposed to be the one that goes straight up to the boss room. So yeah, that's the one I want. So we'll check that one out first. And actually, I wonder if... God, this elevator goes up a long way. Whoops, no, damn it, Holy cow, that's a long way down. My god. Bring that back. Oh, damn it, you know what? I shouldn't have brought it back up. Because, if I die to the boss, then I'm going to have to, I'm going to need it all the way back down there again, so... You know... If you can stand on the roof of this thing, there's gotta be a reason, because all of the other elevators in the castle have pointed roofs. Maybe not. Okay, well... Up we go! Alright, I'm done screwing around with the elevators. Just wanted to make sure I wasn't missing anything. I mean, I doubt they would put a second slab in one of the other elevator shafts, but... You never know. This game has set a number of other fairly strange precedents, so... I'm not prepared to take that sort of thing on faith. Gonna play it safe, you know? Oh, and whose soul sign is this? Cirrus. I'm gonna hold off for now, I think. Okay, good.
Dear, another dogged contender.
Gwyndolin?
Welcome, unkindled one, purloiner of cinders. Mind you, the mantle of Lord interests me none. The fire-linking curse, the legacy of Lords, let it all fade into nothing. You've done quite enough. Now have your rest.
Okay. Lorien, what the... Oh, all right. Wait a minute, Lorien? Elder Prince, so he had a bro, I guess. Oh, that's dirty. That is real dirty. So is that, holy cow. Okay, so these I guess it's not safe to go for that second attack ever against this guy. Oh, but oh, for God's sake.
For that is our curse.
So, what, Prince Lothric controls the curse? Lovely. Okay. Okay, so from the looks of things, I have to somehow hit his back to hit Prince Lothric. I see. I'm assuming that that's going to just continue happening, that if I don't kill Lothric before I kill Lorien, he'll just keep reviving Lorien. What a blasted hassle. It's interesting, though, that they handle like a dual enemy boss fight. I thought, when I realized it was two enemies, I thought it was going to be something more like the Throne Watcher and the Throne Defender from Dark Souls 2. Wait, what? What the hell? Oh, I didn't send... Oh, this was another... There were two elevators. Then... Oh, okay. So there was some super secret treasure down here. A titanite slab, of course. Okay, I get it. So there was no point to these elevators having flat roofs, but there was just... God damn it, so... Now I'm gonna have to go checking every other blasted elevator in Lothric Castle. I'm not going to do that on camera. I'll wait till the episode's over. Well, in some ways, I'm glad, actually, that the fight with Prince Lothric works the way it does. Because, at least in the case of this fight, the enemies that you have to kill actually stay together. If Lothric hangs onto his brother's back, then it at least should be possible for me to keep them together. Okay. Of course I have to do phase one all over again. This teleportation crap is really obnoxious, though. And you know, actually, interesting, so... Ah. Alright. Oh, but that doesn't cover a lot of ground, that fire wave. Okay. Oh, so that's not a safe time to hit him then. Okay, that was definitely delayed. That is obnoxious, that running... I can't see him. Well then! Okay, we don't need to see that a second time. Even that's not safe. Oh, lovely. Ugh. So there is no safe chance to heal anywhere near him. Even after dodging one of his attacks, he recovers before you can finish using Estus. That's really a pain. So I guess the only safe opportunity to heal is to back off, and if you back off, then he starts using his ranged attacks. Damn it, and I think I forgot to send the elevator down again. All right, well... Oh, no, I didn't. Yes, I did. Damn it! And now I'm stuck. Lovely. Ha! What?! Seriously?! Thanks, FromSoft. I demand a reimbursement for my ember. All right. Well, I guess I'll be a little bit more careful of that next time. I wonder what the... for God's sake, really? So it reset? FromSoft, come on. Okay, let's try this again. Maybe now. Maybe now. I suppose it was probably inevitable that this happened eventually. This is just my luck. I guess I shouldn't be surprised. But hey, after I found that jump in Farron Keep, a bunch of you were encouraging me to continue trying to break the game, so I guess I just unintentionally granted your wish again. But boy, if I'd known that that was going to happen, I wouldn't have even bothered trying. I guess you just can't do this kind of stuff on purpose, can you? Alright, and this time, for the sake of all that is holy, they don't... Yeah, okay, he didn't see me. Alright. Third time's the charm, eh? Really? Okay. Bad read, but God. And another bad read. All this delayed stuff. And that crap. Oh, okay, and there I would have had time if I'd waited. For God's sake, and... So you have to back away from him if you want to heal at all. Where is he? Okay. How did that not hit him? Well, I guess I'll give this one more shot and start cutting attempts, because I don't imagine too many people want to sit through much more of this. This boss really seems to be focused on punishing just about everything. And with all that teleportation, I wonder how you're supposed to deal with him as a mage. That's got to be even worse. I'm also realizing now just how short the range on this rolling R1 is. This actually used to have some range in Demon's Souls, but I guess that's been nerfed in Dark Souls 3. And now when I get on this elevator, I'm always going to be second-guessing myself as to whether I'm going to be going the right direction. Since there are two elevator cars. Okay. So actually, let's see. Does the blue bug pellet overwrite? Yes, it does. Damn it, I thought so. Then, no, stamina regeneration is going to be more valuable. Ugh. That was pure luck. That was... Okay, at least she can get out of the way of that Estus Punish. I couldn't lock onto him. Too early. Crap, stamina. Oh, but if you're right up close to him, his rear punish misses you. Okay, that's good to know. I guess you just have to get away from him when that soul crap is happening. Okay. Oh, no, you don't. Oh, you piece of shit. Phew. Okay. Well, that actually was not as bad as I thought. It seems that Lothric is indeed the priority target in that situation, and killing him takes precedence over Lorien being revived. So actually maybe that fight is pretty fair. Especially knowing that you can just stand right up close to him and those punishing swings of his will just go over your head. Knowing that makes the fight a lot less irritating. I wonder if there's any way to get up there. I also have to wonder, what's the deal with Lorien? Did Prince Lothric just enslave his brother or something? Or did his brother already go hollow? Huh. One way or the other, I guess, I can't blame him for not wanting any part of the firelinking stuff. So, let's see what we got out of that. Soul of the Twin Princes. The two princes rejected their duty to become Lords of Cinder and settled down far, far away to watch the fire fade from a distance. A curse makes their souls nearly inseparable. Oh, okay, so that's why. And... the Lothric bloodline was obsessed with creating a worthy heir, and when this proved impossible, it resorted to unspeakable means. Suffice it to say, the path to linking the fire is a cursed one indeed. Oh, okay, so... creating a worthy heir. I wonder if that's what all the business with King Osiris was all about. With him trying to create a child born from dragons. There's one other thing I'm realizing now that... um... No, you know what? I don't even care. I was gonna say, I've been informed that I could put on the Scholar's Ring, and unlike in Dark Souls 2, where that didn't work, apparently it would put me over the intelligence limit that would allow me to go speak with the sorcery vendor, but screw sorcery, I don't care. Let's head back to Firelink Shrine, I guess. And finish upgrading my equipment. Actually, let's see what the... What Ludlith has to say. What I can get from the Prince's souls.
The eyes show...
Lothric's Holy Sword? And of course, it has a freaking dexterity requirement, and faith as well. Prince Lothric's Straight Sword, blessed by Emma with potent magic. Interesting. Young Lothric was meant to be a champion and was expected to wield this platinum sword, but some things will remain distant dreams forever. From the looks of him, he was born pretty weak. Assume stance to imbue the sword with sacred light and use the strong attack to release light together with a great thrust of the sword. Okay. Lorien's Greatsword. Ultra Greatsword of Lorien, Prince Lothric's older brother, cast in smoldering molten steel and stained black. Maybe this will shed some light on Lorien. Before Lorien embraced his brother's curse, he was a knight who single-handedly slayed, the word is slew, actually, the demon prince? But the victory eternally scorched his sword with flame. Lunge forward to transform smolder into flame, and follow with a strong attack to launch flame across the ground. So I guess that's the special attack he used. And for God's sake, it's a split damage weapon, and it requires one more dexterity. Well, I wonder if it's any better than the... Oh, what's it called? The profane flame sword.
I took the mantle.
Let's give it a look and find out. Oh! Totally not the Smelter Demon sword at all. Oh, but it has, Oh, of course. Wow. It has the moveset I want. Or one very much like it. Really, the backstep attack, the backstep R2 is a thrust. And the rolling attack is a thrust as well. Alright, well, what about the weapon art? Oh, it's Stomp! And it just imbues the sword with fire, although I bet if I follow up with a strong attack... Okay. Uh, Alright, what does this do for my attack power, actually? .405 with the buff. And .325 without it. So it's I guess a flat 80 damage. You know, I wonder.
Well, 'tis good to see what needs me.
I wonder. Because I can at least upgrade it now.
Pretty.
What are we working with? 577. So this still. And it'd probably be in the neighborhood of around 600.
What neat.
If I used a slab. Well over 600.
Pretty, be careful.
And what stats does it scale with again? Everything! It scales with everything. But yet, the Dragon Slayer Great Axe is still going to be better in every way when the when Lorien's Greatsword is not buffed. Yeah, but I don't know. I think I'll just stick with what I've got for now. If it looks worth a slab, then I'll investigate that. But
now invade and come.
So nothing new. All right. Well. Oh right, and. I guess I'm supposed to offer the cinders now. But I wonder. You know, actually, and I've beaten the princes, so.
Welcome home, husband. Ashen one, my thanks for the eyes thou'st given, but fire keepers are not.
Oh, right, okay. So, I don't know then. I guess maybe I have to place the ashes in order to proceed, because I would have thought, given how much hand-holding this game seems to like doing, I would have thought that the path to whatever happens after this would open up immediately after I beat the Lothric twins. So I guess I have to place these. Oh, well that's lovely. Sorry, Yorm. Right. Oh, it's the ashes of a bunch of those idiots. Okay. So, offer Lothric's ashes. Anything new to say now that I've put ashes down?
The eyes.
No.
I took the chew.
Well. Nothing. Huh. And Aldrich's ashes are what? I can't even tell. Looks like, intestines or guts or something. That's lovely. Oh, and she moved down to the bonfire again. Wait a minute, did she? No, she didn't. I thought for a minute she took off her,
The five lords sit their five thrones, all thanks to thee. Most worthy of lords, Ashen One. With the lords as thy witness, bend thy knee afore the bonfire's coiled sword, and let the lord's embers acknowledge thee as their true heir, a true lord, fit to link the fire.
You know what, though? I don't think I'm going to link the fire. I see Kriegswolf as the sort of person who would rather be a Dark Lord. So, that linking the fire stuff...
Ashen One, might that fire keep these wounds. Oh, well, Ashen One, is this truly thy wish?
Yeah, that linking the fire stuff I don't think is for me. Let's get this dark party started right.
Of course, I serve thee, and will do as thou bidst. This will be our private affair. No one else may know of this. Stay thy path. Find lords to link the fire, and I will blindly tend to the flame until the day of thy grand betrayal.
Betrayal?
Ashen One, forgive me if this soundeth strange. The eyes show a world without fire. A vast stretch of darkness. But 'tis different to what is seen when stripped of vision. In the far distance, I sense the presence of tiny flames, like precious embers, left to us by past lords, linkers of the fire. Could this be what draws me to this strangely enticing darkness? Ashen One, if thine heart should bend, kill me. And strip these eyes from my person. I will return as the firekeeper I once was, as it has always been.
Oh, okay, so this is kind of like the ending path in Demon's Souls, killing the Maiden in Black. What, are they giving us a way to back out, then? If we change our mind?
Ashen One, if thine heart should bend, kill me. And strip these eyes from my person. I will return as the firekeeper I once was, as it has always been. Farewell, Ashen One. Mayst thou thy peace discover.
Wow, okay, so, she's totally on board with this. Alright. Before I do anything else, then, I'm going to level up a little
Ashen
bit.
With the a true lord. Very well. Then take no.
I want to be able to carry this crossbow without being over encumbered. I do not see where I. Well, I'll have to go one point at a time, then.
Farewell, me. Ashen,
all right,
very
one
well
more.
Farewell, Ashen One.
Just exactly 70%. My god, that could not have worked out more perfectly. Okay.
Ashen,
then,
very well. Then
let's even it out. We'll go to 60 here. I don't think that's going to make a significant enough difference to stamina. So I'll just put it all into vigor.
Farewell.
And we'll use... You know what we'll do before anything else? I want to spend these souls. Because I don't want to go to New Game Plus like this, so... What can we get? Definitely some ammunition. Huh. Two more. More of those. Some of those. Okay, well... Well, screw it. I'm going all in then. Want as many bolts as I possibly can before I move into New Game Plus. And is there anything else? Whoa! When the hell did this get here? Thank you very much, I think I will. And you know, all those sets of equipment. All that trash I'll probably never wear, but that I want for collection purposes. Did I just buy a goddamn thief hood? And the assassin stuff, too. All I want is the unique stuff. Oh, hang on a minute. That's Lorien's stuff. Armor of Prince Lothric's older brother, Lorien. This black-dyed brass helm is patterned with flame. Lorien, raised as a knight, is said to have been left mute and crippled by his younger brother's curse. It is also said that Lorien, in fact, wished it so? Wow. Okay, so that's why he was crawling around on his knees. Okay. This black-dyed brass armor was passed down to him from the royal family. Hmm. And I already have Lothric's equipment because I found it in the chest. Well, I guess, I'm not able to afford all- Oh! This is Cirrus's stuff. I guess, she must be dead. Damn. They all seem to die! They all just show up inexplicably dead for no apparent reason. Tire of a knight from the Sunless Realms, known for their resistance to both magic and the dark, formed of a silk veil and a silver headband. Sunless knights serve the nameless moon, and perhaps it is for this reason the attire casts a feminine silhouette. Oh, okay. Metal plating and chainmail treated with silver. Serve the nameless moon, and perhaps it is... Okay, so this is the same stuff. Well, that I don't need. These I don't need, and those I don't need.
Ashen one.
Okay. So, here we go, then.
Noble Lords of Cinder.
Oh no, Ludlith!
And the lords go without thrones.
Surrender your fires to the true heir. Let him grant death to the old gods of Lordran, deliverers of the first flame.
Old gods of Lordran, eh? And of course, Kiln of the First Flame. I suppose this should not surprise me at all. And in fact, I cannot say that it does. All right, that's that taken care of. What have we here? All of the candles are out. Can I warp from here? I can. Firelink Shrine or the Flameless Shrine. Huh. I'll go check out what's outside in a moment, but... Oh. Of course. Yeah, no, they knew. There's no way. So the thrones are still the same. And I guess... I guess that's it, but... Oh, but there's no, no Andre area. And this stuff is bricked up, or else just non-existent. Okay. Oh, wow, all right. Why? Why? Oh, proceed to the first flame. Oh, hang on a minute. I wonder if this is supposed to be Lordran. Matter of fact, I suspect maybe it is. Because, she said something about granting death to the old gods of Lordran, and... This definitely... Definitely fits Lordran in terms of location, way up on the top of a mountain. Let's, Oh, I have my crossbow now, so... Well, it's pretty nondescript. And not especially distinct as Lordran in particular, but and I suppose it reasonably could be. Oh, okay, and there's that looks like an arch tree. So, yeah. Yeah, I guess it's feasible for this to be Lordran. Okay. Clearly there's no going down there. I guess, yeah, I guess this is probably a good opportunity to wrap things up for now. I'm going to do just that, because we are at well over an hour. I've gotten quite, speaking of getting wrapped up, I've gotten quite wrapped up in progression to what I can only assume is the end game here. So, thank you all very much for joining me, and I will catch you all next time. Take care, everybody.